So now we'll discuss the second generation of the cellular telephony. So in the previous video lecture, we have discussed the first generation cellular telephony. Okay, so in that first generation, we have to use the analog signals for the voice communication. Okay, so here in the second generation of cellular telephony, we have to use the digital signal for the voice communications. Okay, so that is the first point. The second generation was mainly designed for the digitized voice. Means to digital signal we have to use for the voice communication here. Okay, and here in this there is a three major systems are involved in the second generation. Okay, so there is a three major systems we will discuss in this second generation. First one is a DAMPS, means it is a digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, and next one is a GSM, a global system mobile communication. Okay, and last one is the IS-95. Okay, so these are the three systems we will discuss in the second generation. Okay, so in this video lecture, first we will discuss the first two systems, that is a digital advanced mobile phoning system and the global system mobile communication. Okay, so IS-95 we will discuss in the next video lecture. Okay, so first we will go to the first one, that is a digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so here the digital advanced mobile phoning system was designed to backward compatibility with the AMPS. AMPS is nothing but advanced mobile phoning system, and it is a digital advanced mobile phoning system. Why we have to use the digital? So in this second generation, we have to using the digital signal for the voice communication. Okay, so that's why you have to use the D, that is a digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so this can be used backward compatibility with the AMPS. So meaning of that, what is the meaning of that is, so here there is a one cell. Okay, so one mobile phone can use the advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, and another mobile phone or the mobile station in that cell use the digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so that's why you have to call as this is a digital advanced mobile phoning system has a backward compatibility with the advanced mobile phoning system. We already discussed the what is the cell. In that cell there is a many mobile stations are present. Previous videos we have discussed. Okay, so one mobile phone can use the advanced mobile phoning system, and another phone mobile system or the mobile station use the digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so that's why here we have to call as a digital advanced mobile phoning system as a backward compatibility with the AMPS, that is advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so next we will discuss the bands. So here digital advanced mobile phoning system uses the same bands and the channel as the AMPS. Okay, so it is also use the same bands as in the first generation technology, that is the AMPS advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so in that we already discussed that there is two for communication channel. One is a forward communication channel and a reverse communication channel. Each channel has a 25 megahertz bandwidth, and each 25 megahertz channel we have to divide it into the 832 channel, and each channel has a 30 kilohertz bandwidth. Okay, so that same configuration we have to use it in the digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so that's why they are told that digital advanced mobile phoning system uses the same bands and the channels as the AMPS. Okay, so next we'll discuss the transmission. Okay, how the transmission will be happen, how the particular person will call the other person through the mobile system. So how that communication or how that voice signal will be transmitted, that we will discuss now. Okay, so we will discuss through the diagram here. Okay, so this is the diagram for the digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so here what is the first point here? There is a mobiles are there. Okay, three mobiles. Okay, so each mobile has generated the voice signal. Okay, the frequency or the bandwidth of that voice signal are 3 kilohertz. Okay, it is the bandwidth of the voice signal. This is the analog voice signal. Okay, and by using the digitizer, okay, we need to convert those analog voice signal into the digital voice signal. Okay, so that digital voice signal has a data rate. We have to call as a data rate in the digital communication or the bandwidth. Okay, so that is a 7.9 kilobit per second. Why we have to use the kilobit per second? So we are representing the digital signal here. That's why we have to use the kilobit per second to represent the bandwidth of the digital signal. Okay, so here by using the digitizer, we need to convert the analog voice signal of 3 kilohertz into the digital voice signal to the 7.9 kilobit per second. Okay, and here we have to use the TDM technique here. Okay, so here all these three channels, okay, so all these three channels, okay, we need to combine here by using the TDMA technique. So in the previous module we have discussed the what is the TDMA, that is a time division multiple axis. Okay, so here whole bandwidth of the channel we can access access at a given time, although we need to divide the whole bandwidth of the channel in timely manner. Okay, so at a given time one station can access the whole bandwidth of the channel, and another time the other station can access the whole bandwidth of the channel. Okay, means in the timely manner we have to divide the whole bandwidth of the channel. Okay, so here in this, these all three channels are combined by using the TDMA technique, the time division multiple access technique. Okay, so there is a totally six slots are present here. Okay, totally six slots. Okay, so these six slots are shared among these three channels. Okay, and here each channel has get the two slots. Okay, so this is the one slot, this is the one, this is associated with the first channel. Okay, and next one is a, this is a second slot, that is a number second slot are associated with the second channel. Okay, and that is a number three slot has been associated with the third channel. Okay, means here the each channel has contains the two slot. Okay, each channel has contained the two slot here. Okay, okay, so there is a totally six slots will be formed. Okay, so this will we have to call as a one frame. Okay, the combination of those six slot we have to call as a frame here. Okay, the frame has contains the six slots. Those six slots are shared among the three channels, and each channel has got the two slots. Okay, next here, so here each frame will transmit, the each frame will be transmit 944 beats. Okay, our each frame has contains the 944 beats here. Okay, and each slot, so each frame has contains the 944 beats. Okay, so this particular frame has contains a six slot. Okay, that frame has contains the totally 944 beats. Okay, and each slot will contains the 324 beats. Okay, so here the six slot will form the one frame. That one frame has contains the 944 beats. Okay, and each slot in that frame has contains the 324 beats. Okay, and it will finally result the 48.6 kilobit per second. It is the beat rate or the bandwidth of the this whole channel. Okay, after the combining that over three channels by using the time division multiple axis. Okay, so the bandwidth of that whole channel will be 48.6 kilobit per second. That is a final beat rate or the bandwidth of the all combined channels. Okay, so channels are combined through the TDMA technique. Okay, so next, this 48.6 kbps digital signal we need to modulate. Okay, at 48.6, okay, the 48.6 kbps digital signal we need to modulate by using the QPSK, that is a quadrature page shift keying. Okay, we already discussed in the previous module what is the quadrature page shift keying here. It is nothing but the combination of two page shift keying, that is a two binary phase shift keying. One is in the in page, another one is out of page. Okay, so quadrature page shifting keying is nothing but the combination of two binary page shift keying. One binary page shifting keying is in page, and another binary page shifting keying is out of page. Okay, so that's why we have to call it is a quadrature page shift keying. Okay, so here we need to modulate the digital signal of 48.6 kbps into the analog signal, that is a 30 kilohertz analog signal. We already know what purpose we have to use the quadrature phase shift keying. The quadrature phase shift keying is mainly we have to use for to convert the digital signal into the analog signal. Okay, same thing here. The quadrature phase shift keying modulating the digital signal of 48.6 kbps into the analog signal of 30 kilohertz. Okay, and after that, here these 30 kilohertz signal, okay, each 30 kilohertz signal will share the 25 kilohertz bandwidth. Okay, that is a 30 kilohertz signal or the 30 kilohertz channel will share the 25 megahertz bandwidth. Okay, so these 25 megahertz bandwidth we have to divide it into the 832 channels as we discussed in the first generation of cellular telephony. So we have divide the 25 megahertz into the 832 channel. So that is a forward communication as a 832 channel and reverse communication as a 832 channel. And each channel is a 30 kilohertz. Okay, so here same thing. These we need to divide this 25 megahertz bandwidth into the 832 channel, and each channel has a 30 kilohertz bandwidth. Okay, so here this 30 kilohertz bandwidth will share the 25 megahertz bandwidth by using the FDMA technique. FDMA technique is nothing but that it is a frequency division multiple axis. Okay, means here we need to divide the whole bandwidth of the channel in the frequency bands. Okay, need to divide the whole bandwidth of the channel into the frequency bands. Okay, and each frequency band we need to assign to the each station. Okay, each station will use that particular frequency band, okay, to access that particular channel or to send the signal to the other devices. Okay, so that purpose we have to use the frequency division multiple axis. So what is the use of the frequency division multiple axis? Here we need to divide the whole bandwidth of the channel into the frequency band, and each frequency band is allocated to the each station. Each station will access those bands to transmit the signals. Okay, so that's why here by using the FDMA technique we need to divide or we need to share this 25 megahertz bandwidth by using the FDMA technique. Okay, so this is the what about the that is a digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, so what is our digital advanced mobile phoning system? So here the first the user will call, that is an analog signal of 3 kilohertz that can be converted into the digital by using the digitizer. That will give the digital signal of 7.9 kilobit per second. Okay, so here these three signal can be shared by using the time division multiple axis here. Okay, so there is a totally six slots are present. Okay, the six slots are shared among these three channels. Okay, and each channel will get the two slots. Okay, and these six slots will form one frame here. Okay, each frame contains the six slots here. Okay, and total number of beats present in the one frame, it is a 944. Okay, and the number of beats which are present in the frame will be 944 beats. Okay, and number of beats present in the each slot in the frame is, that is a 324. Okay, so 324, there is a totally 6 slot into 6, so that will give the 944 beats that will be contained in the frame. Okay, and after that, that will produce the 48.6 kilobit per second, that is a signal bandwidth. Okay, that is a what output of this particular channel. Okay, that is a 48.6 kilobit per signal that can be modulated into the analog signal by using the quadrature phase shift keying. Okay, that can be modulated into the 30 kilohertz signal. Okay, so here each 30 kilohertz signal, so here each 30 kilohertz signal, okay, will share the 25 megahertz bandwidth by using the FDMA technique here. Okay, by using the FDMA technique, it will share the 25 megahertz bandwidth of the channel, and that 25 megahertz bandwidth of the channel we need to divide it into the 832 channel. Okay, so this is how the communication, how we need to perform the transmission in the digital advanced mobile phoning system in the second generation technology. Okay, so this is a first one, that is a digital advanced mobile system. Okay, so there is another point they are given, the digital advanced mobile phoning system has a frequency reuse factor 7, means we need to group the 7 cells, or we need to create the cluster of 7 cells here. Already know what is the reuse factor of a 7 in the previous video lectures we have discussed, because we have need to avoid the reusing. A neighbor cell cannot use the same set of a frequency. Okay, for that we have to use the reuse pattern. Okay, so if the same cells are used the same frequency, that will create the interference disturbance. So that's why we need to avoid. For that we have to use the reuse pattern. So here we have to use the reuse factor of a 7, okay, to avoid the interference from the one cell to the other cell. Okay, so this is all about the digital advanced mobile phoning system. Okay, and next we will go to the second one. Okay, that is a GSM, that is a global system for the mobile communication. Okay, global system for the mobile communication. So is mainly we have to use to replace the number of incompatibility. Okay, number of incompatibility, the first generation technology. Okay, that means we need to, with this particular global system for the mobile communication, we have to use PAL to replace the whatever the difficulty we have to face at the time of first generation technologies. Okay, to replace that we have to use the global system for the mobile communication. Okay, so in that first we will discuss the bands here. Okay, so what are the bandwidth, what are the frequency range we have to use in this global system mobile communication. Okay, so here first point, here also we have to use the two bands for the duplex communication. Okay, so as the diagram here indicates that. Okay, here we have also used the two bands for the duplex communication. Okay, two bands means one band is a forward band. Okay, and another one is a reverse band. Okay, so these are the two bands we have to use it in the global system mobile communication. Okay, the first one is the forward band, second one is the reverse band. Okay, so here the reverse band has a 25 megahertz bandwidth. Okay, and forward band is also 25 megahertz bandwidth here. Okay, and these 25 megahertz bandwidth we need to divide it into the 124 channels. Okay, and each channel has 200 kilohertz bandwidth. Okay, so that is a what forward communication and the reverse communication here. Okay, so here there is a, in the band there is a two bands are there, one is the reverse band, second one is the forward band. Okay, So the reverse band frequency range is 890 to the 950, and reverse and forward band frequency range will be the 935 to the 960. Okay, so means each band has a bandwidth 25 megahertz. Okay, those 25 megahertz bandwidth we need to divide it into the 124 channels. Okay, and each channel has a 200 kilohertz bandwidth. Okay, so these are the bands we have to allocate for the global system for mobile communication. Okay, so here forward band and the reverse band each has a 25 megahertz bandwidth, and 25 megahertz bandwidth we have to divide it into the 124 channels, and each channel has a 200 kilohertz bandwidth. Okay, so that is a what bandwidth we have to allocate it for the global system for mobile communication. Okay, so next we will discuss the transmission. Okay, so we'll discuss the transmission through the diagram here. Okay, so here also the same thing, the user use the mobile station or the mobile phones to call. Okay, so he will transmit the analog Y signal each of 3 kilohertz. By using the digitizer, we need to convert those analog Y signal into the digital Y signal. Okay, and the bandwidth of each digital Y signal is 13 kilobit per second. Okay, and all those channels we need to combine through the TDMA technique, that is a time division multiple access. Okay, so here what happened, the totally 8 slots are, okay, so the total 8 slots are there, these all channels are share these 8 slots. Okay, and these 8 slots we have to share the one brain, means these combination of these 8 slots will form one frame here. Okay, so each slot will contain here 156.25 okay beats. Okay, each slots will contain, that's that what they have given here. Okay, so here the each slot will carry 156.25 beats. Okay, so here each slot will carry the 156.25 beats. Okay, and these slots will be sharing the each frame. Okay, by using the TDMA technique, those 8 slots will form the one frame. Okay, so there is a totally it will send 26 frames here. Okay, so through this particular channel, that whatever the we combine the channel by using the time division multiple access. So whatever the channel it will form after the combining, so that will send totally 26 frames. Okay, so those 26 frame we have to call as a, it is a multi frame. One multi frame is equal to the 26 frames. Okay, so those 26 frame we need to transmit to the this particular combined channel. That combined channel are combined through the time division multiple axis. Okay, so here what is a multi frame? One multi frame has been equal to the 26 frame. Okay, and each frame has contains the 8 slots, and each slot has a 156.25 beats. Okay, and these 8 slots are shared among the different channels. Okay, and after that it will give the total bit rate of the bandwidth of that combined channel will be the 270.8 kilobit per second. Okay, and the duration we have to require to send one multi frame is, the duration we have to require to send one multi frame is, that is a 120 millisecond. That 120 millisecond we have to require to send the one multi frame or the 26 frame through through the channel, with the channel bandwidth has been 270.8 kilobit per second. So how to calculate this particular bandwidth of the P tray? Okay. So here the channel data rate is equal to, okay. So here one slot has contains the 156.25 bits. Okay. So there is a totally 8 slots in the each frame. Okay. And after that 26 frames are there. Okay. Totally 26 frames are present. Okay, and how much time we have to required? Okay, how much time we have to required to send the one frame in the multi frame? That is a 120 millisecond. Okay, so we need to make the addition of these all terms. Then we'll get the channel data rate is 270.8 kilobit per second. Okay. 156 is a beats we have to transmit it in the one slot. Totally 8 slots are there. Okay. 8 slots will create the one frame. So here we have to transmitting the 26 frame in one multi frame. Okay. How much time we have to require to send the one multi frame? That is a 120 millisecond. Okay. So here we need to take the how much time we have to require to send the one frame in the multi frame. That is a 120 millisecond. So that will give the channel rate as a 270.8 kilobit per second. So in this way we have to calculate the bit rate, that is a 270.8 kilobit per second. Okay, so next here this 270.8 kilobit per second digital signal we need to modulate into the analog signal of 200 kilohertz by using the JMSK. JMSK is nothing but it is one of the standard form of frequency shift key. It is one of the standard form of the frequency shift key. Okay, so by using that standard form, we need to modulate the digital signal of 278 kilobit per second into the analog signal. There is a 200 kilohertz. Okay, and here the 200 kilohertz signal will share the 25 megahertz bandwidth by using the FDMA, that is a frequency division multiple access technique. Okay, so these 25 megahertz bandwidth we have to divide it into the 124, as already we discussed here. Okay, so that is a 25 megahertz. So each forward band, reverse band has contains a 25 megahertz bandwidth. So that each band has been divided into the 124 channel, and each channel has a 200 kilohertz bandwidth. Okay, so these 200 kilohertz bandwidth will share this 25 megahertz bandwidth by using the FDMA, that is a frequency division multiple access. Means we need to allocate the one fixed frequency band to the each station to access that frequency band to transmit the signal. Okay, so this is a what about the GSM global system for the mobile communication. Okay, so here what happened, as already told the user has call, that the user will transmit the analog voice signals 3 kilohertz by using the digitizer. We need to modulate that analog voice signal into the digital signal. Okay, each of 30 kilobit per second bandwidth. Okay, and these channels are combined here through the TDMA, time division multiple axis. Okay, so here thus 8 slots are there, that is a shared among the channels. Okay, that 8 slots will form the one frame. Okay, so each slot will contain the 156.25 bits. Okay, and after that we need to combine how these frames are, the 8 bit frames are shared in the one multi frame by using the TDMA technique. Means here one multi frame is equal to the 26 frames. Okay, and the duration required to send one multi frame is, that is a 120 millisecond. Okay, so the total bandwidth of the combined channel, like channel which are combined through the TDMA technique, is 270.8 kilobit per second. And these digital signal we need to modulate by using the GMSK, that is one of the standard form of the frequency shift gain, that will modulate digital signal into the 200 kilohertz analog signal, that will share the 25 megahertz bandwidth by using the frequency division multiple axis, and these 25 megahertz bandwidth we have to divide it into the 124 channels. Okay, so this is a what GSM global system for mobile communication. Okay, and up to that we'll discuss the what is the multi-frame components here. So here what happened, multi-frame components we will discuss here. Okay, so here each slot we have to allocate 65 bits for the user data. Okay, each slots of the frame. Okay, so here for the each slots of the frame we have allocated 65 bits for the user data. Okay, and for that user data we need to add the some error control bits. Okay, we need to add the some error control bits to that user data, and that will be increased into the 114 bits per slot. Okay, and after that we need to add the some TDMA time division multiple access control bit to the error control bit and the user data, and that will increase the bits to the 156.25 bits per slot. Okay, so that is a nothing but one slot has contains the totally 156.25 bits. Okay, such a 8 slots will form the one frame. Okay, and such a 26 frames will form one a multi-frame, that is a one multi-frame is equal to the 26 frames, and each frame has a 8 slots. Okay, among those 26 frame, 24 frames we have to use for the voice communication or the traffic frames. Okay, and 2 frames we have to use for the control the communication. Okay, and total duration we have to require is 120 millisecond to transmit the one multi-frame over the channel. Okay, so that's why they are given the 120 millisecond for the one multi-frame. Okay, so this is the multi-frame component. Okay, so 65 bits we have to allocate it for the user data. Okay, for that user data we need to add the error control bits, and that will be increases to 114 bits. Okay, and for that we need to add the TDMA control bits. Okay, that will be increased into the 156.25 bits per slot. Okay, such a 8 slots are present. Okay, that combination of that 8 slots will create one frame. Okay, and such a combination of 26 frame will create one multi frame. Okay, among those 26 frames, 24 frames we have to use for the voice communication, and 2 frames we have to use for to control the communication. Okay, so the duration is here 120 millisecond to transmit the one multi frame over the channel. Okay, so this is a multi frame component. Okay, so this is all about the global system for mobile communication. So next we will discuss IS-95 in the next video lecture.